Dear students, good morning to one and all. Unit 1, Plant Physiology. The first chapter, Transport in Plants, will be totally completed. Today, we are going to discuss about the second chapter, Mineral Nutrition. Mineral Nutrition. Dear students, all living organisms or needs to be organic nutrients such as carbohydrates, proteins and fats, as well as inorganic nutrients available from minerals. So dear students, most of the plants are grown in the soil, but some plants are not grown in the soil. So this phenomenon first discovered by Julius von Sachs in the year 1860. He was a German botanist. The phenomenon are known as hydroponics. What is the meaning of hydroponics? Dear students, the technique of growing plants in a specific nutrient solution is known as hydroponics. Hydroponics. The technique of growing plants in a specific nutrient solution is known as hydroponics. Generally, all plants are grown in the soil to be absorbed water and mineral nutrients. But few plants are not grown in soil, only grown in one type of nutrient solution. So this phenomenon are named as hydroponics. By means in the absence of soil. Dear students, hydroponics first demonstrated by Julius von Sachs in the year 1860. He was a great German botanist. So totally absence of the soil, only grown in some plants in a specific nutrient solution, that is called hydroponics. So the specific nutrient solution are here purified water or mineral nutrient salts. So dear students, by this method the mineral elements were identified and deficiency symptoms were discovered. In this method of hydroponics. This hydroponics are very useful commercially to be vegetable plants or in tomato, seedless cucumber and lettuce. These plants are not grown in the soil, only grown for the specific nutrient solution such as pure water or mineral nutrient salts. In those plants, tomato, seedless cucumber and lettuce, these plants all are hydroponics plants. Okay, now dear students, this is a hydroponics, the definition in hydroponics. So totally absence of the soil to be require a one specific nutrient solution, that is purified water or mineral nutrient salts. So next 70. Okay, na? Total helmets, not essential or not non-essential. Total helmets, total mineral helmets, total mineral helmets, total helmets are present in a plant of plant kingdom. Total plant kingdom. All plants. So not only angiospermic plants and gymnospermic plants, including bryophyta, pteridophyta, including bryophyta and pteridophyta. So dear students, total helmets are present in a plant of plant kingdom 60 to 70. 60 to 70. But total helmets are present in a plant. Total helmets are present in a plant. Angiospermic plant, either gymnospermic plant. Approximately 30 to 40. 30 to 40. Don't confuse our year. Total helmets are present in a plants of plant kingdom, such as bryophyta, pteridophyta, includes angiosperms and gymnosperms. Total helmets are here 60 to 70. But total helmets are present in plants, especially one type of plant, angiospermic plant, either gymnospermic plant. Total helmets are here 30 to 40. 30 to 40. And of these, non-essential elements are here 13 to 23. Non-essential elements are here 13 to 23. But essential elements are here 17. But essential elements are here 17. So, dear students, non-essential elements are here 13 to 23. But essential elements are here 17. Essential elements are in macro elements and micro elements. Essential elements are in, one is macro elements, second one is micro elements. Macro elements are in 9, micro elements are in 8, totally 17. So 17 and 30, that is called 30, or 17, 23, that equal to 40, that equal to 40. Here let us show. Total helmets are present in plants 30 to 40. So dear students, non-essential helmets are here 30 to 23. By means, these helmets are not included on the plants. Not essential. Not essential. Not requirement. Not urgently. These helmets are not urgently or not essential or not requirement in plants, approximately 30 to 23. But essential elements are here 17. Of these, macro elements are here 9, micro elements are here 8, totally 17. So, dear students, 17 plus 13, that equal to 30. 17 plus 23, that equal to 40. So, dear students, total helmets are present in a plant 30 to 40, but non-essential elements are present in a plant 30 to 23, but essential elements are present in a plant 17. Of these, micro elements are here 9, macro elements are here 9, micro elements are here 8. Okay, now, and again, macro elements are here 9, but non-mineral elements are here 3 and macro mineral elements are here 6, totally 9. Non-mineral elements such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. So these are macro elements and these are micro elements. Macro elements are here 9, micro elements are here 8. But first, second, third, these three macro elements or macro nutrients are here non-mineral elements. How many? 3. And remaining macro mineral elements 6, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium and sulfur. So totally 6. So dear students, non-mineral elements 3. macro mineral elements 6, but macro elements totally 9, micro elements totally 8, total essential elements are here 17. So dear students, total essential elements are here 17. These essential elements are broadly divided into two categories based on the quantitative requirements. These two categories are here. First category, macro elements are macro nutrients. Second category, micro elements are micro nutrients. What are the character features of macro elements? Next, what are the character features of micro elements? Dear students, total essential elements are here 17. The essential elements are broadly divided into two categories based on the quantitative requirements. These two categories, first category, macro elements are macro nutrients. Second category, micro elements are micro nutrients. Okay, now, so dear students, macro elements are here how many? 9. Micro elements are here how many? 8. How many macro elements? 9. How many micro elements? 8. What are the character features of macro elements? Macro elements or macro nutrients are present in all of the plant tissues. In all of the plant tissues. Okay, now this is the very important. Macro elements or macro nutrients are present in all of the plant living tissues. So these macro elements are having to larger amount by means excess of 10 m more kg dry matter. That is the macro molecules. Macro elements or macro nutrients are in 9. These are present in all living plant tissues. These are larger amounts by means excess of 10 m mole in case dry matter. That is macro elements or macro nutrients. Macro elements includes carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, and sulfur. These are 9 macro elements or macro nutrients, dear students. But first 3 macro elements are here: carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Carbon symbol C, hydrogen symbol H2, oxygen symbol O2. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. These 3 elements are framework elements or structural elements of a cell. Non-mineral elements. Dear students, first carbon, second hydrogen, third oxygen. These 3 macro elements or macro nutrients are named as framework elements or structural elements of a cell. Structural elements of a cell. Give the example for carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen to be made a carbohydrate or glucose. So the glucose, the carbohydrate are containing carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, that is structural element of a cell. CO2 and H2O. That is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. First three macro elements such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen is mainly obtained from atmospheric CO2 and H2O. Atmospheric CO2 and H2O. Remaining six. That is macro mineral elements. First three are non mineral elements. Remaining six are macro mineral elements. That is nitrogen, N2, phosphorus, P, potassium, K, calcium, Ca, magnesium, Mg, sulfur, S. So these macro elements are these macro nutrients. Macro nutrients are available in soil by plants through the roots by means several mineral nutrients are in the soil absorbed by plants through the roots. So nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur, these are macro elements or macro nutrients to be available for the soil to be easily absorbed of the root of plants. Okay, now next one is here. Micro elements or micro nutrients are in ant. So these elements are these nutrients are present in all plant living tissues in shorter amount. These are larger amount, but these are shorter amount by means less than 10 m mole of kg dry matter. 10 m mole of kg dry matter. That is micro elements and micro nutrients. These micro elements or micro nutrients includes iron, manganese, molybdenum, zinc, boron, copper, nickel and chlorine. Iron the symbol Fe, manganese symbol Mn, molybdenum symbol Mo, zinc symbol Zn, boron symbol Br, copper symbol Cu, nickel symbol Ni, chlorine symbol Cl-. So these are 8 micro elements or 8 micro nutrients. Dear students, these essential elements is always play a prime role in main important component of biomolecules. Biomolecules at the same time as a main important component of energy is also responsible of ATP molecules. ATP molecules and also main important role in the metabolic activity as well as to be role of permeable membrane and maintain of water potential of a plant cell sap and activity of enzymes and photosynthesis and respiration process as well as to be including electron transport system. So this is the importance of a play role of essential elements. Those essential elements are here 17 of these 9 macro, 8 micro, but both are essential elements are involved in the component of biomolecules, in the component of energy to be relation of ATP molecules, in the component of metabolic activity and also as well as semi-permeable membrane of activity and activity of metabolic process such as photosynthesis and respiration process and enzyme activity and electron transport systems. So this is about essential elements at the as well as hydroponics. Okay, now thank you. Dear students, previous class we will discuss about mineral nutrition in essential elements. How many types of essential elements? Two types of essential elements based on the quantitative requirements. Those two essential elements are here. First one, macro elements are macro nutrients. Second one, micro element are micro nutrient. 17 essential elements are here. Of these, 9 macro elements are macro nutrients and 8 micro elements and micro nutrients. Dear students, today we will discuss about the role of macro elements or macro nutrients. Okay, dear students, macro elements are here 9, but 3 elements are in non mineral elements such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Remaining 6 are macro mineral elements, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur. Dear students, 3 are non mineral elements or framework elements or structural elements of a cell. Structural elements of a cell. These three elements are here carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. To be making one carbohydrate or one glucose or one type of sugar. So these three elements are three non-mineral elements to be obtained from atmospheric carbon dioxide and atmospheric water, that is CO2 and H2O. Okay, now next coming to discuss about remaining macro elements, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur. We will discuss about one by one. So first macro element, that is nitrogen. So dear students, nitrogen are also available from the soil, and then after this nitrogen directly not enter of the plants. So this nitrogen to be converted, first nitrite, then will be converted nitrate, finally converted ammonium. Dear students, nitrogen is one of the essential macro mineral element available from the soil. Then after this nitrogen not directly enter the plants. So this nitrogen is converted to nitrite NO3-, then after converted to nitrate NO2-, and finally converted to ammonium, that is NH4+. This nitrogen to be utilizing all parts of the plant. Why? Because nitrogen is the major essential mineral element required by the plants. So this is a lipid acids, vitamins and hormones. This nitrogen is rich in all parts of the plant. At the same time, this nitrogen to be making of proteins, nucleic acids, that is DNA, RNA, vitamins, soluble vitamins, non-water soluble vitamins, and hormones. This is a significance of nitrogen. Second element are here, phosphorus. So, phosphorus is also to be soil, but plants are not directly absorbed of the phosphorus. So, this phosphorus is converted into phosphate, that is orthophosphate, So, dear students, those plants to be absorbing phosphorus, that is orthophosphate, this phosphorus to be increasing all parts of the plant, and what is the role of phosphorus? This phosphorus is also constituted of cell membrane, certain proteins and nucleic acids. This phosphorus to be making a cell membrane and to be making a proteins as well as to be making a nucleic acids. So, dear students, nitrogen and phosphorus, both are very very essential to be plants. These two are very very essential elements and play a similar role that is nitrogen, phosphorus, and another one are here, third element, potassium. So potassium is absorbed from potassium, that is divalent cation, that is K plus, and this potassium only occurs in vegetable tissues, leaves and buds. This potassium to be utilized in vegetable tissues, leaves and also buds. What is the role of potassium? So, dear students, potassium is a maintenance of anion cation balance in cells, opening and closing of stomata, and activation of enzymes. Potassium plays a major role, that is always maintenance of anion cation balance in cells. Positive charge of anions and negative charge of cations to be equilibrium is always balanced. And the opening and closing of stomata. So some plants stomata is opening during daytime. Some plants stomata is opening during night time. Depend upon to the concentration of potassium. Influx reflux of potassium and activation of enzymes. So several enzymes to be involved in photosynthesis respiration process. These enzymes are activated by potassium. Okay, here. And fourth element are here, calcium. So, in this calcium to be absorbed in form Ca2+, that is divalent calcium ion. So, this calcium to be used in the meristematic and differentiation of cells. Calcium to be utilized in the vegetable tissues and differentiation of the cells. Vegetable tissue is divided into number of cells. These cells to be make a one part of the plant body structure. And what is the role of calcium? This calcium is always synthesis of cell wall, formation of magnetic spindle fibers and photolysis of water. Cell is covered by a protective layer, that is cell wall, cell wall is made is always calcium and formation of mitotic spindle fibers. One mother cell is divided into two daughter cells. These two daughter cells to be separated one pole to another pole is always to be move opposite poles within the help of spindle fibers. Within the help of spindle fibers, these spindle fibers to be make a calcium and photolysis of water. Dear students, the splitting of water and to be liberate oxygen due to photosynthesis, that is called photolysis of water. In this reaction are involved calcium. In this reaction are involved calcium. Okay, now the water is splitting and to liberating of oxygen during the photosynthesis, that is called photolysis of water. That is called photolysis of water. Next, fifth element are here, magnesium. Magnesium is available from Mg2+. This is a divalent cation. And in which part of the plants? All parts of the plants. Magnesium is also useful in all parts of the plants. What is the role of magnesium? So this magnesium is always activation of enzymes in photosynthesis and respiration processes. So this magnesium is always activation of enzymes to be photosynthesis and respiration process. That is C3 cycle, C4 cycle, CAM cycle, as well as glycolysis and respiration process. Glycolysis and respiration process. This process are to be utilized into several enzymes. These several enzymes are to be activated one element, that is magnesium. That is magnesium. And at the same time, synthesis of DNA and RNA. Nucleic acids are of two types, that is DNA and RNA. So this DNA and RNA to be synthesized by magnesium. To be synthesized by magnesium. As well as, so the magnesium to be constituted within the chlorophyll. Constitute within the chlorophyll and to be make a ribosome structure. To be make a ribosome structure. That is the role of magnesium. That is the role of magnesium. And next, last sixth element are here, sulfur. So sulfur is absorbed from sulfate. So all plants is not directly receiving of the sulfur. This sulfur is converted to sulfate ion. This sulfur is converted to sulfate ion. So this sulfate ion to be utilized in all parts of the plants. All parts of the plants. And what is the role of sulfur? So this sulfur mainly constitutes within the two amino acids. These two amino acids are very very important, such as cysteine and methionine. Cysteine and methionine. At the same time, the sulfur to be activated of coenzymes. Activated of coenzymes. Common enzymes are here and coenzymes are here. Such as coenzymes NAD+, FAD+, NADH and FADH2. So NAD+, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. FAD, flavonoidinate dinucleotide. These two are very very important coenzymes. These coenzymes is always activated by sulfur. And sulfur to be forming disulfur bridges. These disulfur bridges to be making a one protein structure. One protein structure. Dear students, this is about the role of macro elements or macro nutrients. So dear students, totally 9 macro elements are here. But 3 are non-mineral elements or framework elements or structural elements of a cell. But remaining 6 are very very useful essential macro elements. Of these, 3 are very very essential macro elements, such as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, that is NPK, that is NPK, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. These the role of macro elements or macro nutrients. In this class we are going to discuss about role of micro elements or micro nutrients. Totally the micro elements are here 8, such as iron, manganese, zinc, copper, boron, molybdenum, chlorine and nickel. Total essential elements are present in their plant 17, but macro elements are in 9 and micro elements are in 8. So dear students, discuss about one by one micro elements. First micro element are here iron. This iron is also available for the soil. So but plants are not directly absorption of the iron. This iron is converted to ferric ion. By means reversible ferrous and ferric, Fe2+ and Fe3+. Okay, clearly understood. Iron is not directly absorption of the plants. In this time, this iron is converted into first of all ferric ion, then after to be reversible ferrous and ferric, Fe2+ and Fe3+. So this ferric ion will be replacing all parts of the plant body or all parts of the plants. What is the role of iron? Dear students, so this iron will be using constituted of ferrodioxide into cytochrome and activates enzymes Dear students, in their photosynthesis process, to be appearing cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So in this cyclic photophosphorylation as well as non-cyclic photophosphorylation, to be replacing some of the iron proteins such as ferrodioxide and cytochrome C, as well as to be activation of the enzymes. This is the main role of iron. Second micro element are here manganese. So manganese is also absorbed of the plants Mn2+ to be replacing all parts of the plants. This is a divalent cation. So manganese is one of the micro mineral elements, is available for the soil, then after to be under the plant parts. So this manganese is converted to Mn2+, that is divalent cation. This manganese are using on the all parts of the plants. What is the role of and what is the significance of manganese? So this manganese are always activate enzymes in photosynthesis, respiration and nitrogen metabolism. Dear students, in plant physiology, to be presence of sunlight, to be presence of oxygen, to be presence of nitrogen, so to be make a mechanisms such as photosynthesis, respiration and nitrogen metabolism. These mechanisms are to be replacing several enzymes. Those several enzymes is always activated by manganese, especially nitrogen metabolism. So the special enzyme nitrogenase enzyme. So this nitrogenase enzyme, the atmospheric nitrogen is converted to ammonia. By means dinitrogen is converted to reduced to ammonia. So in this reaction to be involved manganese. manganese, and as well as photolysis of water. So same in the photosynthesis, the water molecule is splitting, then after to be liberate a oxygen molecule during the photosynthesis, that is photolysis of water. That is photolysis of water. Third microelement are here, zinc. So zinc is also available for the soil, but not directly under the plants. So these plants to be absorption of one direct cation such as Zn2+, such as Zn2+. This zinc are to be using all parts of the plant bodies. So what is the role of zinc? What is the role of zinc? So the main role are here, activates carboxylase enzyme and nitrogen metabolism and synthesis of IAA. So in this zinc is always activation of carboxylase enzymes such as Rubisco enzyme and PEP enzyme, Rubisco, ribulose bisphosphate carboxylase and oxidase enzyme, PEP, phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase enzyme, by means these organic acid to be make another organic acids in the presence of carbon dioxide, in the presence of carbon dioxide, and synthesis of IAA, by means synthesis of one plant growth hormone, that is auxin, that is auxin. So mainly first synthesis of auxin, that is IAA, indole 3 acetic acid. So indole 3 acetic acid are developed to one micro element such as zinc, such as zinc. There secretes fourth micro element, that is copper. So copper is also available in the soil, but plants are directly not under the absorption of copper. So this copper is converted into cupric acid. This copper is converted into cupric oxide. Cupric oxide. So that is one type of direct cation, Cu2+. Cu2+. In this copper, to be using all parts of the plants. All parts of the plants. Dear students, what is the role of copper? What is the role of copper? This copper is always to be utilizing cytochrome C oxidases in mitochondria and plastocyanin in chloroplast. Plastocyanin in chloroplast. Dear students, photosynthesis occurs in chloroplast, respiration occurs in mitochondria. Mitochondria carries the electron transport system, chloroplast is also carries electron transport system. So these two are electron carrier proteins. These two are electron carrier proteins. One is cytochrome C, another one is plastocyanin. Another one is plastocyanin. So cytochrome C to be utilizing one enzyme, that is cytochrome C oxidase. Cytochrome C oxidase. The activation of cytochrome C oxidase in mitochondria, the activation of plastocyanin in chloroplast within the help of copper. Within the help of copper. Dear students, fifth microelement, that is boron. So boron is also available for the soil, but plants are not directly receiving of the boron. This boron is converted to borate. This boron is converted to borate ion. So this boron is also using of all parts of the plants. So what is the role of boron? What is the role of boron? So boron is mainly membrane function and pollen grain germination and cell elongation and cell differentiation. Membrane function. So dear students, cell is covered by cell wall and cell wall is covered by cell membrane. So the mainly cell membrane function, osmoregulation. Osmoregulation. So in this function to be is always helping of the ion, that is boron, that is boron, and pollen germination. So the power of matter to be released several pollen grains these bulbs to be reaching the foam, female come of the stigma, then after the stigma receiving of the pollen gland, this pollen gland to be easily germinated and finally to be resulted to two male gametes with the help of boron and cell elongation. So smaller size of the cell to become a larger size with the help of boron and cell differentiation. One cell is divided into two cells, two cells is divided into a group of cells with the help of boron. Okay, now here is question. Next one, sixth micro element, that is molybdenum. Molybdenum is also available for the soil. This molybdenum is not directly enter of the plants, so this molybdenum is converted to molybdate divalent cation. So this molybdenum is also using all parts of the plants by means the plant body of root system, shoot system, such as stem, leaves, flowers, fruits, and also seeds. So what is the role of molybdenum? So the main role are here component of several enzymes in their photosynthesis process, in their respiration process, in their nitrogen metabolism process, to be utilizing several enzymes. Every enzyme to be having internally in molybdenum. So next seventh micro element are here chlorine. So chlorine is also available for the soil, but this chlorine is not directly absorption of the plants. This chlorine is converted to chloride ion. So this chlorine are also using all parts of the plants. Okay, now so what is the role of chlorine? Chlorine is always anion cation balance of cells. In the macro elements such as calcium. Calcium is always anion cation balance of cells, as well as chlorine is also anion cation balance of cells, and as well as photolysis of water. What is the meaning of photolysis of water? By means the water molecule is splitting or spitting of water to be elaborate of oxygen during photosynthesis. That is called photolysis of water. That is H2O gives to H2 plus O2. So in the to be utilizing chlorine as well as manganese, chlorine, and also calcium. So this is a macro element. These two are micro element. One water molecule is splitting to be elaborated hydrogen into oxygen, but this oxygen are to be utilizing in the photosynthesis process. Okay, now last micro element, that is nickel. Nickel is also available for the soil, but not plants directly receiving of the nickel. Nickel is converted to a divalent cation, that is Ni2+. This nickel is also using on the all parts of the plants. What is the role of nickel? So dear students, this nickel is always using activate urease enzyme and induce disease resistant in some plants. So dear students, this nickel is always activate of urease enzyme and to be controlling of induce disease resistant in some plants. So dear students, so this is importance of micro elements. So clearly understood. So this is about role what is the role of micro elements? Macro elements and micro elements. Macro elements are here 9, but micro elements are here 8. But dear students, some of the beneficial elements is also are here, such as silicon, cobalt, sodium and selenium. These four are beneficial elements. These four beneficial elements only to be utilizing in higher plants, such as angiospermic plants and gymnospermic plants. Okay, now dear students, clearly understood. Totally essential elements are utilizing in their plants 17. Of these, 9 are macro elements and 8 are micro elements. And 4 beneficial elements is also available for the soil. These beneficial elements only receiving of the some higher plants, such as angiospermic plants and gymnospermic plants. So what are those of beneficial elements, such as sodium, silicon, cobalt and selenium. Cobalt and selenium. Okay, now thank you. Dear students, previous classes we will discuss about role of macro elements and role of micro elements. Today we are going to discuss about deficiency symptoms of essential elements and deficiency symptoms of micro elements. So dear students, first we were learning about the critical concentration. What is the meaning of critical concentration? Dear students, the concentration of essential elements below which plant growth is retarded is termed as critical concentration. Once again, dear students, what is the meaning of critical concentration? The concentration of essential elements below which plant growth and development is retarded is termed as critical concentration. Dear students, the element is always said to be the deficiency of symptoms in certain plants below the critical concentration. Below the critical concentration. Dear students, since one or more elements are involved in a specific structure and functions of the plant cells. If one cell is absent or one element is absent, if one of the element is absent, so in this time totally, so the morphological changes of the plants. So this morphological changes to be activator of deficiency, to be activator of deficiency in certain plants, that is called the deficiency symptoms. That is called the deficiency symptoms. Since one or more elements are involved in a specific structure and functions of the plant cells. If the absence of one element, so in this time totally it will be difficult of morphological changes. This morphological changes to be activated of deficiency in their certain plants. That is called the deficiency symptoms. That is called the deficiency symptoms. Dear students, to be observed deficiency symptoms of essential elements includes macro elements and micro elements. Some of the deficiency of macro elements, some of the deficiency of micro elements to be causing of some symptoms appeared in plant loose or total plant body or appear in flowers. Dear students, to be discussed about one by one. So first one here deficiency symptoms and next one here elements. First column deficiency symptoms, second column elements. So first deficiency symptoms are here chlorosis. First deficiency symptoms are here chlorosis. Chlorosis means loss of the chlorophyll. A green plant containing chlorophyll, so hence to be is always appearance green in color. But here some of the deficiency of essential elements. So in this time, so the leaf, so is loss of the chlorophyll. So to be appeared yellowish color, to be appeared yellowish color, not greenish color. Why? Because so due to some of the absence of essential elements. So the diseases are named as chlorosis. The diseases are named as chlorosis. Chlorosis means loss of chlorophyll. Then after to be appeared yellowish in color, not appeared greenish in color. Why? Because some of the helmets are not involved. So in those of helmets are here nitrogen, sulfur, molybdenum, magnesium, potassium, iron, manganese and zinc. And next one here deficiency symptoms necrosis. Necrosis means the death of the tissues, especially the death of the loose tissues, the death of the loose tissues such as mesophyll and vascular bundles. Mesophyll and vascular bundles, that is named necrosis. Okay, now necrosis means death of tissues, especially death of leaf tissues such as mesophyll cells and vascular tissues including xylem and phloem. Why because deficiency of elements such as potassium, magnesium, calcium and chlorine. Third deficiency symptoms are here inhibition of cell division. Generally one cell is divided into two cells is divided into four cells is divided into a group of cells. This is a development of plant growth. But some of the plants cells is not divided. Especially some of the herbs plants and some of the shrub plants and also some of the tall tree plants. So these plant cells are not divided into number of times. Why because deficiency of some of the essential elements such as nitrogen, sulfur, molybdenum and potassium. Next, fourth deficiency symptoms, delay flowering. Generally always to be making a food material and all roots to be absorption of water and mineral nutrients. These water and mineral nutrients and food materials to be reach of the buds, that is apical bud or kernel buds. These buds are after modified to flowers. But in those of buds are not modified to flowering, so many days are delay. Why? Because some of the deficiency essential elements such as nitrogen, sulfur and molybdenum. This is about deficiency symptoms of essential elements including macro elements and micro elements. But deficiency symptoms are only micro elements. Deficiency symptoms micro elements. Dear students, first column disease, second column plant, third column helmet. First disease are here, motile leaf. So motile leaf disease appear in citrus plant. So in which element, in which micro element are deficiency, that is zinc. Dear students, motile leaf disease appear in citrus plants. This disease is caused by one of the micro element, that is zinc. So the deficiency of zinc micro element to be causing of motile leaf in citrus plant. And second disease are here, dieback. So dieback disease are appeared in citrus plant. So to be causing of one of the micro element, that is copper. So the disease name are here, dieback. Third disease name are here, Artra. So Artra disease to be appear weeds. So to be causing of one of the deficiency micro element, that is boron. Fourth disease are here, biptyl. Biptyl are appearing in cauliflower plant. So to be causing of one of the deficiency element, that is molybdenum. So fifth disease are here, browsing. So to be appeared in legume plants, to be causing of one of the deficiency micro element, such as chlorine. So sixth disease are here, mouse ear. So mouse ear disease appear to be pecan nuts. So to be causing one of the deficiency of micro elements such as nickel. So anyhow, so some of the micro elements to be causing of some of the deficiency symptoms in the some plants, especially motile leaf are appeared citrus in plant. Why? Because deficiency of zinc element. Dieback disease are appeared in citrus plant. Why? Because the deficiency of copper, that is cupric oxide. Heart rot disease are appeared in wheat plants. Why? Because to be deficiency of boron element. Biptyl disease are appeared in cauliflower plant. Why? Because to be deficiency of molybdenum element. Browsing disease appeared in leguminous plants. Why? Because to be deficiency of chlorine element. And mouse ear disease to appeared pecan nuts. Why? Because to be deficiency of nickel element. So dear students, this is about deficiency symptoms of essential elements and deficiency symptoms of micro elements. Okay, now dear students, previous classes we will discuss about mineral nutrition in essential elements, how many types of essential elements, what is the role of macro elements, and what is the role of micro elements, and deficiency symptoms of essential elements. Dear students, today we are going to discuss about metabolism of nitrogen. Briefly discuss about nitrogen cycle. Dear students, nitrogen is one of the essential mineral element required in large quantities of plants. So this nitrogen apart from the carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So dear students, this nitrogen is always constitutes within the amino acids, proteins, vitamins, chlorophylls and enzymes. So this nitrogen is also available for both nature and agricultural ecological system. Dear students, this nitrogen is always exist as two that is nitrogen. Thus nitrogen exists as two atoms is linked by very strong triple covalent bonds, that is N triple bond M, that is N triple bond M. This is the importance of nitrogen. So dear students, discuss about nitrogen cycle. What is the meaning of nitrogen cycle? So dear students, the cyclic movement of nitrogen, the cyclic movement of nitrogen from atmosphere to soil and soil back into atmosphere, that is called nitrogen cycle. Okay, now clearly understood what is defining a nitrogen cycle. The cyclic movement of atmospheric nitrogen from atmosphere to soil and from soil back into atmosphere, that is called a nitrogen cycle. By means nitrogen first of all available atmosphere, then after to be reach soil and soil back again turn up the atmosphere. This is our cyclic process, that is called the nitrogen cycle. So this nitrogen cycle are involved in 5 steps. How many steps are here? 5 steps. First step are here nitrogen fixation, second step are here nitrogen acylation, third step are here ammonification, fourth step are here nitrification, fifth step are here denitrification. Nitrogen cycle are involved in 5 steps. These 5 steps are namely: first step nitrogen fixation, second step nitrogen acylation, third step ammonification, fourth step nitrification, fifth step denitrification. Dear students, first step are now nitrogen fixation. What is the meaning of nitrogen fixation? Dear students, the molecular nitrogen, the molecular nitrogen. So dear students, the process of conversion of molecular nitrogen is converted to ammonia. Molecular nitrogen is converted to ammonia or nitric oxides or nitrogen oxides. That is nitride and nitrate. That is called nitrogen fixation. That is called nitrogen fixation. Once again, what is the meaning of nitrogen fixation? The process of conversion of molecular nitrogen is converted to ammonia or nitrogen oxides such as nitrite and nitrate, that is called nitrogen fixation. That is called nitrogen fixation. So simple of this is a molecular nitrogen is converted to ammonia. This nitrogen fixation occurs in two methods. First method are here biological method, second method are here physical method. Biological method, so the molecular nitrogen is converted to ammonia by one of the prokaryotic organisms. Prokaryotic organisms especially bacteria, that is known as biological method or biological nitrogen fixation. Biological method or biological nitrogen fixation. The molecular nitrogen is converted to ammonia by prokaryotic organisms, especially bacteria, that is called biological method or biological nitrogen fixation. Given the examples for here, pre living aerobic microbes, that is Acetobacter, and pre living anaerobic microbes, that is Protospirillum, and cyanobacteria or blue green algae, that is Nasta and Arabina, and symbiotic nitrogen fixation, that is Rhizobium bacteria. So these roots are in legume plants. And another symbiotic nitrogen fixation, that is branchia, but these roots are in non-legume plants. The best examples for here, biological method or biological nitrogen fixation. So here, free living aerobic microbes or aerobic bacteria. Given the example for here, Acetobacter or Pyrethrum. Pre-living anaerobic microbes or bacteria. So given the example for here, Protospirillum, and cyanobacteria or blue green algae, that is Nasta and Arabina. Symbiotic nitrogen fixation, that is Rhizobium bacteria. Another symbiotic nitrogen fixation, that is Branchia. These are the examples for biological method or biological nitrogen fixation. And another one here, physical method. This is a biological nitrogen fixation. So the atmospheric nitrogen is converted to ammonia. This is a biological nitrogen fixation. And physical method or physical nitrogen fixations. So dear students, industrial and electrical. Industrial nitrogen fixation and electrical nitrogen fixation, both two are physical nitrogen fixation or physical method. Industrial nitrogen fixation and electrical nitrogen fixation, both are physical method. So dear students, so forest fires and industrial accumulations and nature of lightning and ultraviolet rays, so to be released some amount of the energy. This energy is converted to nitrogen. This is the one example of the physical method in nature, lightning and ultraviolet rays to be providing some amount of the energy. This energy are converted to nitrogen and nitrogen converted to ammonia. And another one here, industrial foundations and forest fires and electrical industries to be the sources of ammonia. Anyhow, the physical method to be available, lightning and ultraviolet rays, industrial combinations, forest fires and electrical industries, so to be released from the sources of ammonia, that is physical method or physical nitrogen fixation. So this is a nitrogen fixation. So first step is completed. Second step is nitrogen assimilation. So already molecular nitrogen is converted to ammonia or nitrogen oxides such as nitrite and nitrate. But here, dear students, the process of absorption of nitrate and ammonia by the plants is converted to organic nitrogen, that is called nitrogen assimilation. that is called nitrogen assimilation. Dear students, the process of absorption of nitrate and ammonia by the plants then after is converted to one type of organic nitrogen, that is called nitrogen assimilation. That is called nitrogen assimilation. So to be made a one type of organic nitrogen. So dear students, in this organic nitrogen are given by in this organic nitrogen, that is plant biomass. So the plant biomass or organic nitrogen are eaten by some of the animal organisms. So these organic nitrogen to be reach in the animal body, that is nitrogen assimilation. Okay, now the process of absorption of nitrate and ammonia by plants is converted into organic nitrogen, that is called nitrogen assimilation. So the organic nitrogen is constituted within the proteins, vitamins, amino acids, hormones, chlorophylls and enzymes. So this organic nitrogen are plant biomass are eaten by some of the animal organisms. So in this time the plant biomass of organic nitrogen to be reached in the animal body, that is animal biomass. Third step are here ammonification. So dear students, plant biomass and animal biomass, then after to be decaying biomass, that is decomposition of organic nitrogen. Decomposition of organic nitrogen of dead plants and dead animals. Is converted to ammonia. That is called ammonification. Dear students, the process of decomposition of organic nitrogen of dead plants and dead animals, that is decaying biomass, is converted into ammonia. That is called ammonification. This is a third step. So okay, now dear students, this is a first step and this is a second step, this is a third step, and fourth step are here nitrification. So dear students, nitrification are involved two steps. First step are here already ammonification to be make a ammonia. This ammonia is oxidized. This ammonia is oxidized by Nitrosomonas and Nitrococcus bacteria to be formed nitrite. This is a first step. Second step are here. So this nitrite is again oxidized. By the nitrobacter. To be formed a nitrate. That is called nitrification. By means ammonia is converted to nitrite. That is called nitrification. So this is a fourth step. This process occurs in soil. Next, coming to fifth step are here denitrification. So dear students, the nitrate is present in the soil. And is converted to nitrogen. That is called denitrification. fifth step are your denitrification. So the nitrate, that is NO3 minus, nitrite NO2 minus, nitrate NO3 minus. The nitrate is present in the soil and is converted to again nitrogen. Is converted to again nitrogen. That is called denitrification. That is called denitrification. So it is involved by some of the factors such as pseudomonas and thiobacillus. Pseudomonas and thiobacillus. Dear students, denitrification is carried out by two bacteria. One is pseudomonas. Second one is thiobacillus. So dear students, five steps are involved in nitrogen cycle. So that is nitrogen fixation, nitrogen respiration, ammonification, nitrification, denitrification. This is a nitrogen cycle. So first step are here. So nitrogen fixation. First step are here. Nitrogen fixation, such as atmospheric nitrogen, involved biological nitrogen fixation, industrial nitrogen fixation, and electrical nitrogen fixation. Second step are here. Nitrogen assimilation. Second step are here. Nitrogen assimilation. Third step are here. Ammonification. Third step are here. Ammonification. Fourth step are here. Nitrification. Fifth step are here. Denitrification. Fifth step are here. Denitrification. So dear students, finally the nitrogen cycle involves three pools. So first pool here atmospheric pool, second pool are here soil pool, third pool are here biomass pool. That is atmospheric nitrogen pool, soil nitrogen pool, biomass nitrogen pool. So once again repeat the nitrogen cycle. The cyclic movement of nitrogen from atmosphere to soil and soil back to atmosphere, that is called nitrogen cycle. This nitrogen cycle are involved in five steps. These five steps, first one nitrogen fixation, second step nitrogen respiration, third step ammonification, fourth step nitrification, fifth step denitrification. So this is about nitrogen cycle. Okay, now thank you. Dear students, today we are going to nodule formation. Dear students, the rhizobium bacteria are closely associated with several legume plants such as alfalfa, garden pea, broad pea, sweet pea, sweet clover, and clover beans. That is soya bean. Dear students, the rhizobium bacteria is closely associated with the root of legume plants to be making a one nodule. This nodule containing rich content of nitrogen. So dear students, how many steps are involved in the nodule formation? So dear students, the rhizobium bacteria is closely associated within the soybean plants of roots. This is a one symbiotic association by means two living organisms are involved. One living organism are here soybean root. Another living organism are here rhizobium bacteria. Dear students, next to be discussed about steps in nodule formation. dear students, nodule formation are completed in four steps. This is a first step. This is a second step. This is a third step. This is a fourth step. So, dear students, this is a TS of soya bean root. This is a TS of soya bean root. TS means transverse section of soya bean root. So, generally, the plants of root eggs is always absorbed of water and mineral nutrients from the soil. So, this root internally containing some parts such as epidermal cells and root eggs below the hypodermis and several layers of cortex below the pericycle. These parts are mainly involved in nodule formation. Dear students, first of all, the rhizobium bacteria is attracted by sugars and amino acids. In these sugars and amino acids to be released, most of the legume root eggs. Okay, now this is a first step. Dear students, this is a TS root of epidermal cells below the hypodermis and below the cortex or cortical cells, and some of the epidermal cells to be produced root hairs. So these root hairs to be released some of the sugars and amino acids in soil. These are soil particles. These soil particles containing several rhizobium bacteria, by means several rhizobium bacteria are grown in soil particles. So, dear students, the soya bean of root eggs are produced sugars and amino acids. So, these sugars and amino acids are attracted by rhizobium bacteria. This is very, very important over here. This rhizobium bacteria are divided in several types. Why? Because already to be receiving of the sugars and amino acids. The rhizobium bacteria to be receiving of the sugars and amino acids. In this time, the rhizobium bacteria is divided to be produced number of rhizobium bacteria. This is a first step. And next, coming to second step over here. So, this rhizobium bacteria to be receiving of the sugars and amino acids. These rhizobium bacteria to be undergo several cell divisions or several binary fusions to be form a several rhizobium bacteria. So, these several rhizobium bacteria to be surrounding the root end. So, in the first step, the root end is appeared straightly. But second step are here, several rhizobium bacteria are surrounding the root end. So, in this time, the root of the root hair of the root tip to be appeared hook or fur like structure. Why? Because several rhizobium bacteria to be surrounding the root hair of the root tip. So in this time, the root hair of the root tip to be appeared hook or fur like structures. Why? Because the root hair is generally to be produced plant cell of the cell wall is made up of cellulose. At the same time, the root of the rootate is made up of cellulose. In this time, the reservoir bacteria has to be produced one type of enzyme, that is cellulase. So, finally, the root tip of the rootate is dissolved. The root tip of the rootate is dissolved. Why? Because those reservoir bacteria to be produced against cellulose enzyme, that is cellulase enzyme. In this cellulase enzyme, to be dissolved of the rootate cell wall. Because students, in this time, the rootate to be making a one infection threat. At the same time, the rootate invade bacteria. Several reservoir bacteria to be enter of the infection threat. So this infection threat containing several reservoir bacteria. So these several reservoir bacteria carrying infection threat into the cortex or cortical cells. Dear students, third step are here. The root air to be form a one infection threat. This infection threat containing several reservoir bacteria, or this infection threat carrying the several reservoir bacteria into the cortex or cortical cells. So, dear students, several reservoir bacteria to be reached cortex or cortical cells, and then after the reservoir bacteria are again divided several times. So, to be form a several rod-shaped bacteria. So, in this time, by means due to cause of the cortex cells or cortical cells and pericycle cells are also under divided. And then after growing for the to be making a nodules. Dear students, generally first to be making of nodule formation in the cortex or cortical cells. So in this cortex or cortical cells of the reservoir bacteria to be form a rod shaped bacteria. These rod shaped bacteria to be causing of divided into cortex or cortical cells and pericycle cells. These cortex or cortical cells or pericycle cells to be divided many times, and growing of the reservoir bacteria to be form a one nodule like structure. This is a third step. And fourth step are here. So the cortex or cortical cells and pericycle cells to be form a one nodule. So this is a mature nodule. So dear students, the center of the mature nodule, containing one red or one pigment. Red or pink pigment, that is called leg hemoglobin. Okay, now the center of the mature nodule containing one red or pink pigment. This red or pink pigment are known as leg hemoglobin. These are the four steps in nodule formation. By means, four steps are involved in legume roots of nodule formation. So, dear students, generally the root nodule containing nitrogenase enzyme, generally containing molybdenum iron protein, molybdenum iron protein and catalysis of the atmospheric nitrogen is converted into ammonia. Dear students, the mature root nodule containing nitrogenase enzyme and like hemoglobin pigment, and the nitrogenase enzyme is containing molybdenum iron protein and also to be act of catalysis by means of in the atmospheric nitrogen is converted to ammonia, that is NH3. So this ammonia is the first stable product in nitrogen fixation. This ammonia is the first stable product in nitrogen fixation. So in the symbiotic association of biological nitrogen fixation, in this symbiotic association of biological nitrogen fixation, so the atmospheric nitrogen is converted to two molecules of ammonia. So in this chemical reaction are here, the molecular nitrogen is converted to two molecules of ammonia by using 8 protons, 8 electrons and 16 ATP with the help of nitrogenase enzyme to be form of two molecules of ammonia and to be loss of protons and to be 16 ADP plus 16 PI. So 16 ADP, that is 16 adenosine diphosphate and 16 inorganic phosphate. This is a nitrogen fixation chemical reaction. This is a biological nitrogen fixation in chemical reaction. So dear students, once again, the atmospheric nitrogen is converted to two molecules of ammonia by using 8 protons, 8 electrons, 16 ATP with the help of nitrogenase enzyme, and also to be released protons and also 16 ADP and 16 inorganic phosphate. 16 inorganic phosphate. This is a chemical reaction in biological nitrogen fixation. And dear students, this nodule containing is also red and pink pigment, that is called like hemoglobin. So like hemoglobin is one of the oxygen scavenger. So why? Because this nodule formation to be mainly involved one type of enzyme, that is nitrogenase enzyme. So this nitrogenase enzyme is always very sensitive to molecular oxygen. At the same time, those resorbing bacteria are growing freely, living in their soil. By means of is always grown in aerobic conditions. But several resorbing bacteria are grown in root of the cortical or pericycle cells to be making a nodules. So these nodules are not released of the oxygen. So in this time, the leg hemoglobin to be protect a nitrogenase enzyme. This leg hemoglobin to be protect a nitrogenase enzyme. So hence they are called oxygen scavenger. So hence they are called oxygen scavenger. So dear students, this is about nodule formation. Okay, now thank you. Dear students, previous class we will discuss about nodule formation within the symbiotic association by means closely associated within the rhizobium bacteria and legume plants. Dear students, today we are going to discuss about fate of ammonia. So dear students, ammonia is converted to ammonium ions. In most of the plants, the accumulate of nitrate as well as ammonium ions. These nitrate and ammonium ions to be making a amino acids. If later the quite toxic in plants and cannot assimilation of amino acids. Anyhow, let us now see the ammonium is to be synthesized of amino acids. Dear students, there are two ways in ammonium ions to be synthesized of amino acids. These two ways are here. First one, reductive amination. Second one, transamination. So, dear students, first we will discuss about reductive amination. Dear students, in this process to be involved ammonium ion react with alpha-ketoglutaric acid. In this process mainly involved ammonia or ammonium ion react with alpha-ketoglutaric acid is converted to glutamate or glutamic acid within the help of glutamate dehydrogenase. That is reductive amination, by means reduced NADPH to be utilizing reduced NADPH to be finally form of glutamate or glutamic acid and also water molecule and NADP. So this is a reductive amination. Once again, reductive amination in this process to be involved ammonia or ammonium ion react with alpha-ketoglutaric acid. This alpha-ketoglutaric acid is in the form of one type of amino acid, that is glutamate or glutamic acid, within the help of one catalyzed enzyme, that is glutamate dehydrogenase. So this is a reductive amination. Why? Because reduced nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. Dear students, glutamate or glutamic acid is the first amino acid. So next, second one, we are going to discuss about transamination. Transamination. So, dear students, transamination means transfer of an amino group. From an amino acid. This amino acid consists of carbon, carboxyl group, amino group, hydrogen group, or any alkali group. Dear students, generally, amino acids containing or consist of middle carbon. So this middle carbon is surrounded by carboxyl group, amino group, and hydrogen group, as well as any alkali group. Dear students, the transfer of an amino group. From an amino acid. to be changing of, to be changing of R1, R2. So in right side already R1 containing amino group, but in left side R1 containing keto group, and in right side R2 containing keto group, but left side R2 containing amino group. So this is a transfer of amino group and keto group with the help of transaminase. Only to be replaced by same constituent within the R1 R2. So only to be replaced by first right side R1 is are here amino group, R2 are here keto group. But in left side R1 are here keto group and R2 are here amino group. So this is transamination. This is transamination, transfer of amino acid in amino group and keto group. So clearly understood. So this is a one type of amino acid. This is a another type of amino acid. So first type of amino acid R1, second type of amino acid R2. So R1 containing amino group, R2 containing keto group. By using transaminase enzyme, thereafter to be change of R1 containing keto group, R2 containing amino group. R2 containing amino group. So that is the transamination. That is the transamination. Okay now. So dear students, two amides are available in plants. That is one amide are here, aspartic, second amide are here, glutamine. These two amides are forming in the aspartic acid and glutamic acid. Aspartic acid and glutamic acid. Dear students, in their protein synthesis, to be involved 21 amino acids. But here, mainly most of the important two amides. These two amides are making up the two essential useful amino acids, such as aspartic acid and glutamic or glutamic acid. So aspartic acid to be produced, aspartic amide, glutamic acid or glutamate are to be produced, glutamic amides. These amides to be making up protein structures, Finally, anyhow, the symbiotic association of soybean plants to be produced high large amount of nitrogen. This nitrogen to be making up urides. That is urea. Dear students, the molecular nitrogen is converted to ammonia. Finally, to be converted to ammonium ions. So these ammonium ions to be established in the well-developed soybean root nodules, to be making a iron nitrogen fixation, to be form up one type of urea, that is urex. Okay now, thank you. This is about to fate of ammonia. Okay now, thank you.